Nice bit.
P-line fluorocarbon. And like I said, that jackhammer. And then the white bird with the soft tip. Those are the things that you want to be successful when you're fishing a chatterbait.
I barely felt him, man. Oh, I barely felt him. There's one, boys, chatterbait. I mean, I barely felt him. Look at him. I mean, he got the tail bunched up and everything before he got it. First one of the day, guys, on the chatterbait jackhammer. How about that? I mean, I barely felt you, dude. Right to the bottom of the mouth. Pretty little guy. Nothing big, but a pretty little one. All right. I just knew the chatterbait down through here was going to be the move. Look at him, guys. See you later, little bud. See you later, little bud. When times get tough, guys, put on that Z-Man jackhammer. When times get tough. And then if you catch one, you go right back in there. Might be holding some fish. There we go, boys and girls. And the way you tell when you get a bite on the jackhammer is that blade will just quit vibrating like you're either hung up in grass, and then just wait a second, keep reeling, just to make sure, and then set it into a mat. I mean, they just can't resist a chatterbait, especially a green pumpkin jackhammer, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm Tyler, All My Larry Fishing, Bass Slingers Pro Staff. We're in Washington, Pennsylvania today, and we're slow rolling the chatterbait. Went back to the cove, tried flipping laydowns, nothing, I mean, not a bite. So I was like, all right, if they're not on the laydowns, they gotta be up here on the rock bank. And so far, my theory is correct. We got one in the boat or on the bank, however you wanna call it. And I'm literally just running parallel, a chatterbait parallel with the bank here, just kinda slow. And that felt like a nice little fish. Like I said, he was a little one. He got his little winner. Oh, another one just came and hit it right there. Oh, I watched him come smoking another one, boys. Another one. I mean, I watched him come up and smoke it. Oh, he's mean because he didn't get a chance to fight. Look at that. He is the longest, skinniest fish ever. Oh, he came up and smoked it. I watched that. Oh. Oh, there's two of them. Look at that. He came up and smoked it. Oh, let's get a picture here in our Bass Slingers gear. Oh, he came up and smoked it. Show you guys here on this camera, like I said, just parallel to the bank. When it gets tough, oh, chatterbait, and that water is cold, guys. That water is cold. There's two of them. Another one. Oh, shoot. Dang, duck. Look at him. He's pissed I caught that fish. Want him on your spot? Look at that. That's the duck. There's three of them. Nicest one of the day. He's not too bad. Look at that. Oh, that just got tight and I leaned into him. What's your problem, dude? Sure, I'm gonna step on him. Right, I'm in your spot. Wrecking bass. There he is, guys. Biggest one of the day. Third one. Bass Slingers, baby. Look at that. He's got a little bit of a belly on him. Makes him different. Shoo. Here's one. How about that blooper reel with the duck? I didn't see you there, dude. I'm sorry. Oh, there's three of them. Yeah, that one just got tight, man. This chatterbait's crucial. I didn't see you. I'm sorry. I am sorry. I'm sorry, bud. I didn't see you. Today, I actually walked like a mile clear back over there to the cove of this place, where it's usually a good spot this time of year, flipping heavy laydowns for bass. Went back there. I was back there for about an hour, hour and a half. Didn't even spot a fish. Saw like little tiny bluegill floating around. So if there's a little tiny bluegill there, there ain't bass there scaring them off. Redirected, came out. I knew this place had a rock bank going up in front of the front wall. Now I know it does get pressured, but not everybody fishes with the Z-Man Chatterbait Jackhammer. Drop that $20, it's 100% worth it. But all I'm doing is, if you look down around here, that whole rock bank, all the way down there, running the Z-Man Jackhammer on it. And bam, we have three fish within like 20 minutes. Let's go, bass slingers. Nice fish. Oh, you are the shortest, heaviest fish of all time, dude. Look at him. He is a little chunk tank, man. Four of them in 30 minutes after no bites. Just by switching the game plan, ladies and gentlemen. Heavy guy, man. I mean, you felt like a giant, dude. Oh, he inhaled it too. That's why the gommies, guys. Oh, that's why the gommies. Look at the belly on you for being a little dude. Look at him, guys. Make sure camera's good and straight. Look at him, guys. Another one. Thank you. There's four of them. All on the jackhammer. They're on this rock bank. They're on this rock bank right now. Oh, I can't make the cast quick enough. That was a nice fish. He just scored. He wasn't like long, but man, he was maybe the shortest, heaviest fish I've ever caught there. I felt him. Oh, I felt him trying to get it in his mouth. Another one. There's five of them, boys. Five of them in like 35 minutes. Five and 35 on the jackhammer. Look at that. Another little one. Thank you, little man. They're up against this rock bank. Little ones can go for a little bit of a ride, huh? Yeah. Oh. Little one. I felt him trying to get it in his mouth. See, you'll actually feel the little ones more so than you will the big ones a lot of times. Because he's got to try to get the thing in his freaking mouth. The big one just swallow it.
Let's go, guys. All right, Tyler, all my Larry Fishing. Bass Slingers Pro Staff. So like I said earlier in the video, there's a cove that if you walk way back around here, you can go back in, and there's a bunch of laydowns and you can go in and flip them. Like I said, I went back there, I flipped for like an hour, hour and a half. I literally didn't even see any movement, saw one little bluegill and nothing else. So I knew the front of the reservoir here had these rocks, this rock bank that runs all across the front of it here where the spillway is right here. So I was like, all right, it's a little bit chilly. Usually rocks will retain heat. So what I did, put on the Z-Man Jackhammer Chatterbait, green pumpkin, 3/8 ounce. That's a Strike King Rage twin tail trailer, 7'1", medium heavy, fast tip, favorite fishing white bird combo. And I just was making repetitive casts, slow rolling it down along the rock bank. and we got five fish in like 30 minutes, and I had two other bites that were little small ones that I missed. But going from zero bites to five in that amount of time, it's all about just making those minor adjustments. 15 pound P-line fluorocarbon, and like I said, that jackhammer, and then the white bird with the soft tip. Those are the things that you want to be successful when you're fishing a chatterbait. But I'm telling you guys, this jackhammer is worth every penny you will pay for it. You will catch 10 times the fish of the amount of money that you paid to get a jackhammer. But I'm Tyler, All My Larry Fishing, Bass Slingers Pro Staff. I was glad I was able to catch some fish for you guys today. It is a beautiful day. It's only like 44, 45 degrees. May have got up to 50 now. The sun came out. Green pumpkin chatterbait was the move today. Fish, they tend to like the green color. So get you either a black and blue, a green pumpkin shad, which is a green and a white, and go out and wreck fish every place you go, just like a bass slinger. I'm Tyler, All My Larry Fishing. Thank you guys for watching today, and thank you for subscribing.